So, it turns out that I've upset half of the audiology community. I recently left the world of audiology divided, with a video receiving some comments from audiologists, such as always, excellent content and advice, or, oh yes, you're not wrong at all, research evidence agrees with you. And then finally, cannot agree more. But then, on the other hand, comments such as this. Disagree with you. I also think making these statements on a public platform like YouTube is really bad. Or I have to stop now because my blood is boiling over this video. And then this isn't helpful. If anything, it builds distrust in our profession. And by the way, I have only added the PG comments today. There were a lot worse. And what was that video about? I was discussing the massive number of patients that have come to see me for help and have purchased hearing aids elsewhere that, in my opinion, haven't been set up correctly with the correct tip on the end of their hearing aids. Whether that's an open fit, closed dome, power dome, or custom mold. And so I've taken it upon myself to try my best to help you, yes, you watching me today, to be armed with as much information as possible so that you know the right questions to ask when you visit an audiologist. There is literally no benefit for me making these videos other than trying to raise the bar in the profession and improve the quality of care that you'll get wherever you go. So why am I telling you all of this? Well, I think it's just about to happen all over again. So today's video is all about real ear measurements, also known as REMS, which I'm going to make an equally polarizing statement now. If your audiologist doesn't perform real ear measurements to set up your hearing aids, if they don't believe in real ear measurements, or if they don't know what real ear measurements are, then it's time to find a new audiologist. And I know I'm not the only one that thinks this. In the last few weeks, the National Board of Health in Denmark recently released a 55-page document around gold standards for hearing aid fittings, which includes the use of real ear measurements. And if an audiologist is found fitting hearing aids without real ear measurements, then can you guess what happens? It is punishable by death. Okay, not quite, but they're now a legal requirement in Denmark. And why am I raising this? It's worth highlighting that in a recent poll that I put out there on YouTube asking how your hearing aids were set up, excluding those of you that don't wear hearing aids at all, only 50% of you had real ear measurements performed. Which, in my opinion, means that 50% of your hearing aids could potentially be working better than they are. Now, this figure may even be inflated further still, as I've seen data showing that in reality it could be as low as 30%. 30%. So I'm keen on you watching this video today. What about your physical setup and how the hearing aids were programmed initially? Were real ear measurements performed? Were they not performed? Or are you not sure? Let me know in the comments beneath this video. And if you're unsure of what REMS are and what on earth I'm talking about, then I'd recommend that you watch on in this video, as my main goal today is to highlight five reasons why REMS are essential for you to get the best out of your hearing aids, and also highlight five reasons. Now, let me rephrase that, five excuses that I've heard for them not being performed. So it makes sense for me to kick off today by explaining exactly what real ear measurements are. Essentially, they're an objective way of performing a hearing test when your hearing aids are in your ears to ensure that they're providing the appropriate output based on your hearing test results. And this is all done by placing an incredibly small microphone down your ear canal within millimeters of your eardrum, and then using a speaker which will be sat in front of you and playing calibrated speech sounds which sound something like this, incidentally,
It's a very good when
at different volumes. This microphone in your ear canal then picks up those sounds at your eardrum, and your audiologist will fine-tune your hearing aids, matching them to targets generated based on your initial hearing test results. It's pretty smart. Now, this method of verification is so powerful that I can have two patients with identical sets of hearing test results, but completely differently set hearing aids based on performing this test. So there are a massive number of reasons as to why you should, without question, have real ear measurements performed. And here are my top five. So the first reason that I think REMS are a non-negotiable is that your hearing aids are programmed based on your hearing test results, aka your audiogram, which is a graph focused on speech sounds showing the quietest sounds that you can hear at different pitches or frequencies. When this information is added to your hearing aid fitting software, it generates the sound that's necessary to compensate for your individual hearing loss. However, that sound is based on average values for average people. And guess what? Only a very small proportion of people out there actually fit into the average category. And so why is this important? Well, your ear canal shape and volume are individual to you, a bit like a fingerprint. And so no two are the same. No two ear canal shape, size and volumes are the same. Performing real ear measurements takes your anatomy into account and confirms whether the sound that hits your eardrum is actually what we think it is when it comes out of the hearing aid. And it provides a live method to be able to fine tune those hearing aids. In essence, real ear measurements provides us with a visual, real-time graph that shows exactly how your hearing aids are performing, providing both a target curve, which is your prescription, and a measured curve, which is what your hearing aid is doing at that moment in time. And if they don't match, then you're not getting what you need. So this isn't guesswork, it's measurable evidence. And I involve all of my patients in the process, well, those that are interested anyway, as it feels empowering, I feel, for you to see this data with your own eyes, and therefore it turns my hearing aid fitting appointments into a transparent, collaborative process rather than just a black box. So the second reason that real ear measurements are essential comes down to speech clarity. So, if I were to ask my patients what their main reason for investigating hearing aids were initially, it would be down to, normally, not always, but down to one of two reasons. Firstly, not hearing people clearly, and secondly, wanting to hear better in noisy environments, which I'll come on to shortly. This is all because typically with a hearing loss that develops as you get older, also known as presbycusis, your ability to hear the higher tones is mainly affected, which are essentially the faint rushes of air between the lips, the tongue, and the the teeth, known as fricatives, plosives, or sibilants, i.e. all of which provide you with clarity and speech understanding. Without appropriate amplification in the higher frequencies, speech will still sound muffled, and those around you will sound like they're mumbling. And so by using real ear measurements, we can correct those gaps and optimize the clarity in the higher frequencies that matter the most, which is exactly where most people and most hearing aid users report their hearing aids falling short. If your audiologist is just relying on first fit or click and fit, which is essentially removing your hearing aids from the box, adding your hearing test results, and then putting them in your ears, then not only could it be that your hearing aids are not providing the level of clarity that you need for your hearing loss, but they may also be providing you with too much sound, making it sound too loud or sharp or harsh. Essentially, this is the same as wearing glasses that aren't correctly set to your prescription and, if anything, over-magnifying. So why would you accept hearing aids that do the same? Real ear measurements aren't just about ensuring that sounds are loud or clear enough, it's also about ensuring that they're not too loud or not too clear. If they happen to be over-amplifying, over time, this can lead to listening fatigue, poor satisfaction, or rejection of hearing aids altogether. As a minimum, your audiologist will measure how your hearing aids react using real ear measurements at three different levels. First of all, 50 decibels, which is for soft speech, 65, which is for normal conversational speech, and then 80, which is how your hearing aid will react to loud sounds when you're in the real world. This will allow them to ensure that soft sounds are adjusted so that they're brought within your audible range, conversational sounds sound natural, and that loud sounds are also comfortable and not too loud. And therefore, it finds a nice, comfortable sweet spot across all frequencies and all volumes of sound. When I fit a set of hearing aids, I always bring back my patients after a couple of weeks of wearing them for them to be fine-tuned based on their experience in the real world. Sometimes I'll see a patient for two or three follow-ups, other times it could be five or six. It really depends on the individual, the extent of their hearing loss, how long they've had it for, plus their previous hearing aid experience. I'll then translate my patient's experiences and feedback into hearing aid language, I know that sounds very geeky, and then make the relevant adjustments. If real ear measurements are performed and the initial fitting is far more accurate, then there is no question that it takes far less time and less follow-up appointments to get the hearing aid programming right. Plus, there's a lot less pressure on you as a hearing aid user to be able to articulate your challenges and difficulties. As far as improving your speech understanding in the presence of background noise, I think it's safe to say that if your hearing aids aren't optimized initially in a quiet environment using REMS, then everything that I've outlined in the previous 4 points applies to background noise too. So when REMS are performed, you will hear better in background noise, no question. So based on what I've said, I'm pretty sure you would agree that this should be standard practice anywhere and everywhere, right? I mean, why wouldn't you want your thousands of pounds worth of hearing aids or dollars to be programmed as accurately as possible? Well, believe it or not, here are 5 reasons why real ear measurements aren't always performed by audiologists or hearing care providers. And I'll be brutally honest here. Reason number 1, very simply put, is that performing real ear measurements takes longer, and some clinics prioritise fast hearing aid fittings over accurate ones. So yes, you may pay less for your hearing aids in these clinics, but it's worth spending the extra cash and having your hearing aids set up more accurately. The second reason that I've been told that real ear measurements weren't performed is because the patient had been advised that the equipment was expensive. I mean, that's not your problem, that's your hearing care providers. Go to a clinic that's willing to invest in themselves, you, and providing the best possible service. The third reason that real ear measurements is not always performed is training. REMS isn't easy, and although training is provided as part of the curriculum in all universities, as far as I'm aware, in my opinion, any job in healthcare is learnt on the job after you qualify. Just as the old saying goes, you learn to drive after you've passed your hearing test. And if that isn't a saying, I think it should be one. It may be that the audiologist has started working in a department that hasn't historically provided real ear measurements. Again, that isn't your problem. You're still paying thousands of pounds for this technology, and you want it to be right. The fourth excuse that I've heard for REMS not being performed is audiologists saying that you don't need it. I mean, sorry, but this is just BS. I have nothing more to say on this. The sound may be okay without it, but could it be better? You don't know. If it's not measured, it's a gamble. Now, don't panic if whilst watching this video, you've just realised that your hearing aids weren't set up using real ear measurements. You can still go back to your audiologist and ask them to perform it at any time that you want, as it doesn't need to be done just at the initial setup. If you're searching for new hearing aids, make sure that REMS is part of the fitting process. Now, of course, none of what I've told you today matters unless you're wearing the right hearing aids for your hearing loss and your hearing difficulties. So to know which hearing aids are right for you, you have to watch this video.